So when you ask ChatGPT a simple question like, what's the capital of France? It gives you the answer because it's easy. But what happens when you ask something like, how was my sales team able to overcome the objection from company X? Or how many of my customers reported a bug on this specific page? Well, ChatGPT will start making stuff up, and he will do it faster than a kid explaining why they didn't do their homework. Stick with me for 10 minutes, and I'll show you exactly how Netflix and Spotify are able to show you which shows or music you like and how to recommend others. And I'll show you how a company can utilize an AI superpower and save a ton of money using vector databases and RAG. We'll break it down in simple terms and analogies so anyone can understand it. And I'll even share a free toolkit to help you implement it right away. For those new to the channel, I'm Remi Taffin, a software engineer with 15 years of experience, and I'm now on a mission to help businesses scale much faster using AI. On this channel, I break down complex AI topics, share insights, and help you stay ahead of the curve. If you're looking to automate your business, make more money while leveling up your skills, you're in the right place. Let's start with the fundamental problem. AI, like ChatGPT, is incredibly smart, but it has one major limitation. It only knows what it was trained on. It's like a friend who went into a coma in 2021 and woke up today. They're super smart, but they have no idea what happened while they were out. And worse than that, ChatGPT doesn't know anything about your business specifically, right? It doesn't know anything about product catalog, company policies, your customer data. When you ask about these things, it does what we all do when we don't know something at a dinner party. It makes educated guesses and hopes no one notices. In AI, we call this hallucination. And it's a huge problem if you're trying to use AI for business. This is what we use vector databases for. What's a vector, you ask? And why do we need a whole database for them? Think of it this way. When you and I look at an apple, we don't see apple. We see a red round fruit. Our brains convert that visual into meaning. AI works very similarly. When it looks at words or images, it converts them into what we call vectors or embeddings, essentially a list of numbers that captures the meaning. For example, the words dog and puppy would have very similar vectors because they're related concepts. Dog and skyscraper would have very different vectors. A vector database is simply a special database designed to store and search these numbers very quickly and find things that are very close to it. So let me show you an example. So let's say we wanted to represent a specific word by its meaning. And the meaning is going to be into a specific list of numbers. In this case, we're going to have a list of two numbers. So let's pick an example. The word dog is going to be here. I'm just picking something random, right? So it's value 3 and 4. So dog has a list of numbers of 3, 4. Now let's take puppy. Puppy might be very similar because very similar meaning. So that would be puppy. Now that forms a group, a cluster of meaning, which is very similar. So you could find human's best friend, you could find a lot of different words within that group, and they would all roughly mean the same thing. Now, if you take cats, well, cats is probably very close, but not the same, right? It's a little further than puppy. So you might have cats that is part of pets, but not part of the dog cluster. So you represent each point by their meaning, and you could have skyscraper, as I said before, that would be here. You could have podcast that would be there. You could have murder mystery being close to podcast because it's in similar meaning, but not the exact same. And each point is represented by different numbers. That's exactly what a vector is. You just put a set of numbers, just like dog. This one is just an example with 3, 4. So now imagine the exact same principle with 1500 numbers, and that's exactly what's happening. And you could put any chunk of text out there and essentially have a set of numbers. And if someone asks something that is similar meaning, then it can find that very quickly. So let me give you an analogy. Imagine a giant library. A traditional database is like searching library by exact book titles or by the author. If you search for Dogs 101, you'll only find the books that actually have that exact title in it. Or maybe you can look for a partial, something like you have dogs in the name. Now, with a vector database, it's like searching by topic. If you search for human's best friend, it might show you books about dog training, puppy health, and anything else that might be related. And if none of those books have the exact same word, canine care in the title, it's still going to find it. This is incredibly powerful because it means the AI can find information based on meaning, not just exact keyword matches. So now let's talk about RAG, which stands for Retrieval-Augmented Generation. If vector databases are the library, RAG is the super smart librarian who takes your question, finds the most relevant books, reads them quickly, then gives you the perfect answers based on exactly what's in those books. So without RAG, if you ask ChatGPT what's our company's refund policy, it might say something like, most companies offer a 30-day return policy. Or worse, it might completely make stuff up. Now with RAG, the system first searches your vector database for information about your company policy. It retrieves the actual policy document and then generates an answer based on that specific information. So let's see how RAG actually works in practice. It's a four-step process. Step one, you gotta prepare your data. You take your company documents, website, product information, whatever you want the AI to know about. Then the system breaks these down into chunks and converts each chunk into a vector. All these vectors get stored in the vector database. Now in step two, when the user asks a question, then the AI will convert that question into a vector. And then in step three, you can find everything that is close to that. So find all the relevant information. The system will search your vector database for vectors that are very similar to the question you asked. It pulls out the most relevant chunks of your original document. And then step four, based on all of that specific context, it generates a smarter answer. The AI combines its general knowledge with the specific information it retrieved. It gives an answer that's both smart and factually accurate about your business. It's like giving ChatGPT a personalized crash course on your business right before it answers each question. The businesses that are implementing vector databases and RAG are seeing some huge business benefits. First of all, accuracy. No more AI hallucinations. That means customers get the correct information. For customization, the AI becomes an expert in your business specifically. For freshness, you can update your database anytime, so the AI always has the latest information. For security, your sensitive data stays within your control. And for cost effectiveness, well, it reduces support tickets and internal knowledge searches by 60 to 80% in some cases. In fact, one study found that companies using RAG or customer service saw a 42% increase in first contact resolution and a 35% reduction in support costs overall. But the biggest advantage is how quickly you can implement this. You don't need to train a custom AI model from scratch. You can leverage existing models like ChatGPT and just connect them to your data. So how do you actually get started with vector databases in RAG? You'll need these key components. One, you need a vector database. Options like Pinecone, Weaviate, Chroma, or Supabase. For document processing, you'll need the tools to convert your documents into vectors. For a RAG framework, you'll need the systems that connect your database to the AI models. And then four, you need an AI model like ChatGPT in order to power those vectors. Now, if that sounds intimidating, don't worry, I've got something to help. I've created a free RAG implementation toolkit specifically for businesses wanting to get started with this technology. It includes step-by-step implementation guide, vector database comparison chart to help you choose the right one, some simple code templates for the most common business use cases, and a free 20-minute consultation with me to answer your specific questions. To get this toolkit absolutely free, just click the link in the description and I'll send it to you right away. Before we wrap up, let me address some common questions I hear about this technology. Is this expensive to implement? Well, not necessarily. There are free and low-cost options for small businesses, and the ROI typically covers the investment within weeks or months, depending on the company size. Do I need a technical team? It definitely helps, but there are now no-code tools that lets you implement RAG without writing a single line of code. What about data privacy? That's a great question. With RAG, your data stays in your control. You decide what information to include and what to keep private. How does this compare to fine-tuning models? So RAG is typically faster, cheaper, and more flexible than fine-tuning, especially when your data changes frequently. It can essentially get you there faster for cheaper. And for those thinking, RAG doesn't work for my company, remember, garbage in, garbage out. Really make sure that the data you pass in is great quality. So to recap, vector databases store your data in a way AI can understand. RAG uses your specific data to make AI responses accurate and relevant. Together, they give AI superpowers that transform how it works with your business. This technology is changing how businesses use AI, moving from general assistant to truly customized AI expert. And the companies that implement it now are gaining a serious competitive advantage. If you found this video helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe for more content that breaks down complex AI topics into actionable business strategies. Don't forget to download your free RAG implementation toolkit using the link in the description. Let me know in the comments what's one area of business where you think RAG could make the biggest impact. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.